Some say sunfish are for kids. This week, our hero will try to prove that bass like them too.
Oh, big one. Big one, stay on. Lower, destroy that thing. Inhale the sunfish. Come here, dude. Come here.
I'm Dave Mercer, pro angler and all-round fishing big mouth. Today, I've got one day on one body of water, and I am surrounded by cameras. Unfortunately for me, but fortunately for you, they're gonna show you everything that happens, and I mean everything.
Bet you thought I was gonna get a backlash.
Welcome to Facts of Fishing, the show. Brought to you by Bass Pro Shops. Your adventure starts here. Shimano, technology you can feel. Yamaha, conquer water. Phoenix Boats. Livetarget, lifelike lures. Jacko, eat, sleep, Jacko. And Rigid Industries LED lighting, excellence in innovation.
Eat it. Oh, he just rolled underneath it. Man, this is one of my favorite times of the year. You know, when you get to this week, I mean, seasons are transitioning. I mean, we're going from summer to fall. I think the first day of fall was, you know, 2 days ago. You get that first cold snap of the year, and those fish know that the easy living that they've been used to, it is about to end, and it's about to end in a hurry. So what do? They charge up to the shallows for one last feeding fiesta. And what are they eating? Well, they're eating this bad boy right here, little sunfish. These bad boys are full of protein, and this is what sees them through the winter. But they know they gotta get them now while the getting's good. Oh, another one behind it, eat it. Come on, take it. The best part about this is it should only get better. You know, the warmer it gets, once I can get out of this sweater and that sun starts warming me up, it does the exact same thing to the fish. And you think of the last time you went fall fishing, this is the time of year where you have three different seasons in one day. And if you can feel that, the fish feel it too. Come on, eat it. Oh, I'm wrapped around camera guy. Got fish exploding on the bait. Eat it. Oh, came back at it twice. I know I should throw the follow-up bait, but I gotta throw my little sunfish. There you go. Eat it. Eat the sunfish. A good one too. Look at that chunk right there. Oh, and man, look how he ate that sunfish. When they're eating it like that, you know you are throwing the right bait. And today, we are definitely throwing the right bait. Fall of the year, they start strapping on the feed bag and munching on sunfish, and it's been a long time since I've been this excited about a bait. I mean, it is the perfect presentation throughout most of the year, but especially in the fall when these bad boys start strapping on the feed bag in the shallows. It's a sunfish smorgasbord, and I love it. You know, one of the reasons myself and so many other anglers are so excited about this particular bait is this whole sunfish deal. I mean, it's nothing new. It's not a secret. For years and years, myself and a lot of other pros have actually been painting hollow body frogs to look like sunfish, you know, adding that extra color to them, because we know this is a major, oh, it's one behind it. Eat it. Eat it. Come on, dude. Eat it. He's still under it. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Oh, come on. How many chances are you gonna give me? I mean, in a prime example, one of the points that I was gonna make is this is not a frog. This has got the exact profile. So no matter how good we were at painting up our hollow, there he is, he ate it. No matter how good we were at painting up our hollow body frog, it didn't look like a sunfish. But now, with this Livetarget Hollow Body Sunfish, it's got the profile. It's not a giant. It's not a giant. But this fish is a storyteller. And what I mean by that is while I was fishing that bait along, I mean, with a hollow body frog that I had painted up, I mean, it may have had the color, but it did not have that exact profile. And with this particular fish, I mean, I was able to throw this bait back 3 times. You seen that little silhouette come off the pads? And he couldn't resist it. They are loaded in there. You just gotta give them what they want. And what they want is pure and simple, just a sunfish. I mean, the water's getting colder and the weak, they die off. And when you come in areas like this, you will see sunfish just kinda, you know, swimming kinda weird and definitely weak and in their last hours of life. Whew. I want bass see that. You know what they hear? Ding, ding, dinner bell. Oh, big one, big one, stay on. Lower, destroy that bait. Inhale the sunfish. Come here, dude. Come here. Get him. Oh, gotcha. Whew. I mean, we're still not talking about a triple sow cow or anything, but boy, there is nothing any more fun than busting them on a sunfish. And the best part is, these fish are basically bonus fish. I was expecting the action to turn on when the sun came out.
This segment is brought to you by ARE Truck Caps. ARE, outfit for life.
Little dude, what is with little guys? Look at him. Bait's half the size of his head. He sure acts like he's a lot bigger though. Oh, big one. Ah, gone. Those are the ones. Busted it. I mean, hammered that bait. I know it's not a tournament, it's just a TV show, but I still don't like losing them. Oh, yeah. Thought he had it. Right now, laddies. All we need is a great big giant one to smash it, to come out of nowhere with utter reckless abandon. We need McGregor. McGregor, the mighty bass. Bascapades. I believe I can fly. I believe I can make the bass fly. Another chunk. You know, one of the keys is always pay attention to your graph. I mean, a lot of times people will get in the shallows and, you know, they basically just close their eyes to the graph. But as we're fishing along, you see this little weed edge out here. Pick up the jig and fire it in there, and there seems to be a bunch of them down there. Oh, this is what fall is all about. Whether you're up in the shallows or fishing the edge like I am right now, fish group up and they munch. And I love it. Oh, got him. Oh, smoked it. Oh, get up here, dude. You gotta love these fall fish. I mean, he's got one thing and one thing only on his mind, and that is munching. That right there is a little chunk. I love it when they munch. Oh my goodness. Eat it. What was that? It was gigantic. Come on. It was either the mightiest little muncher or a triple sow cow. Behind it. Eat it. Oh. Please be big and please eat it. It's Houdini. Houdini. You think he's got it, but he does not. The thing you gotta remember is every single movement you make with that bait, that fish feels. I mean, a lot of times people get into a bad habit of just taking a bait like this and cranking it back to the boat. That's one of the things I love about this sunfish. I mean, you can really add a lot of action without moving the bait. I mean, you pull it into one of those pockets, and if you slackline pop it, it will just sit there and work in that exact area. So you're moving, but you're not moving. And it drives fish crazy.
Oh yes, big one, giant, Houdini. Oh, stay on. Oh my goodness, this is a big fish. I don't even know if this is a bass. I think this is not a bass. This is not a bass. Oh, this is a whole different creature. This is a whole different creature. Oh, I knew that was a bigger fish. But unfortunately, that is not the dude we're after. That right there is about the size where these dudes start getting fun. I mean, I hate little hammer handles. When they get that big, I'll take them. Now you do me a favor, and don't you tell any of those bass that we're looking for. Oh, this is a nice boy too. I mean, normally they splash you, but he's a nice gator cod.
Landed. Shunk. Get out of here. Gotta clean up around the house. God, smoked it. My goodness. Like a cinder block in the water.
That is not a giant by any means. But boy, when they bust on it like that, it is addictive. Junior, tell Big Mama we're coming.
Oh, little dude, get up in here. Small fry.
I think this sun is turning them on.
They're starting to munch. Dying.
Whoo! Angry. That's the coolest thing about this type of fishing, is you're just always aware. There's always fish moving, whether it's bass or sunfish or crappie, it doesn't matter. There's always something moving. And the whole time I'm scanning the area, I'm kind of looking for edges inside of areas. This whole thing, I mean, every pad is an edge, but if you look, there's some patterned edges in some areas where there's two different weeds that intersect. Or maybe it's just shore. Or a big opening in the grass. Anything that looks different.
Come here, dude. Come on up.
Smoked it. That chunk absolutely dusted that little sunfish, and I can't say it enough. I mean, people think a sunfish is panfish, something for kids to catch, but boy, they are also something that bass eat. Put this sunfish in front of these bad boys, and as you can see, it is munch time. You know, when you get a big, powerful rod like this in your hand and 65-pound test braided line, you can't help but want to meet on everything. There's times for doing that, but there's also a little bit of finesse involved with this style of fishing. And what I mean by that is when you're popping this little sunfish along, it's incredible the structure you can get it through. I mean, I'll reel it over trees, I'll reel it over buckbrush, you know, the pads, everything. But every once in a while, you may get that super sharp trocar hook hung up on just a little limb or something like that. You're gonna want to reef on it to get it out of there. And you may have to do that, but initially what I'll do is I'll just slowly pull on it. Because what'll happen a lot of times is that'll be stuck on a branch or something, and that fish can see that stuck on the branch, and you pop it off. If it flies back to the boat, it's not gonna come and chase it. If it just slithers off, it may slither off in front of a fish and get eaten.
There he's gone. Get out of there.
You aren't near big enough to act that tough. You get out of here. Oh my goodness, he's a big one too. Huh. Thought I had him, I saw him grab it. Team decision, do I go back with this or do I throw the follow-up bait, quick?
Go back.
Oh, okay.
Oh. Oh, there he is. Oh. A good one too. Come here, dude. Get up in the boat.
That dude absolutely dusted that Livetarget sunfish. I popped it along and I'll be honest, I mean, I had to make a team decision. I really was gonna go in with the follow-up bait, but boy, you cannot replace the excitement of an explosion on one of these hollow body baits. Manga. Sunfish time is the right time. And they love eating them. That is awesome.
This segment is brought to you by Hook Performance Fishing.
Back in the Badlands, where no lure has been. Not too many anglers will throw in the Badlands. When it comes to this particular style of fishing, it's all about having the right gear. I mean, you go out and do this with your medium light rod and it's not gonna stop you from getting hits. You're gonna get just as many hits, but you're gonna be pretty frustrated because you're not gonna get those fish in the boat. I'm using an extra heavy rod, 65-pound test, Power Pro Max Quattro line. And the reason I'm using that particular line is it's that much thinner than standard braid. So what it allows me to do is just use 65 and still get that long bomb cast. In the past, I used to have to use 50, and I really wanted to use 65, but I went to the 50 just for the casting distance. With Max Quattro, you can have the best of both worlds. He rolled on it back there. I got a fish there, I'm gonna have to walk in and get it.
There's one way back in the trees. Come on through the trees.
Where's Danny's off? You wonder why you need 65-pound test braid when you're doing this style of fishing? And that is exactly why. You can throw it on what some would think is land and get fish to the boat.
Oh, there he is. Come here, dude. Get out of the trees and get into the boat.
You give them what they want, and they'll give you what you want, and that is them. How awesome is it to have this critter come out and smoke that sunfish and literally have to drag him over three trees and a stump? See ya.
Get up here, little guy.
Junior. You know, the cool thing about days like today is I am 100% sure the perfect presentation is this hollow body sunfish. Why? Well, basically, not just because the fish are absolutely inhaling the bait, but also because every single time, you know, I'm up here raised above these lily pads and all these openings, that you can see all the sunfish like skirting away and they're in there. So you know if they're in there and the bass are in there, one of them's getting eaten. behind it.
Oh. Stay on. There he is. Another good one. Just smoked it. Come here, dude. This is a big one. These are the kinds you want right here. Look at the size of this dude. Come here, open your yap. That's the ones you want right there.
Look at that dude right there. You know you're throwing the right bait when they eat it like that. That little hollow body sunfish is gone. That, my friend, is what you call matching the hatch. Ooh, what an absolute swamp donkey. There is no more fun way to catch them than have them explode on your sunfish in the jungle.
Dave fished for 6 hours and 43 minutes, made 908 casts, and caught an incredible 19 fish. And that's the score. Now it's time for the facts. The star of today's show was obviously the Livetarget Hollow Body Sunfish, fished on a 7'6" extra heavy Shimano Jacko Poison Adrena rod, paired with a Shimano Metanium XG, spooled up with 65-pound test green Power Pro Max Quattro. For a follow-up bait, Dave Texas rigged a Jackal Chunk Craw with a skirted worm weight, rigged on a 5-aught Trocar TK-130, fished on a 7'6" extra heavy Shimano Jackal Poison Adrena rod, paired with a Shimano Metanium XG, spooled up with 65-pound test green Power Pro Max Quattro. And that's the facts.